In this video, I enlist the help of ChatGPT to build a simple AI that differentiates between cats and dogs. Can an AI build an AI? Watch to the end to find out. Let's get started. So first I'm going to ask it, how do I create an AI that detects cats and dogs in Python? All right, so it's going to give me the basic steps. So first, we need to gather and prepare data. We need a data set of images of cats and dogs to train with. And it's saying you can either create your own data set by collecting and labeling the images, or you can use a pre-existing data set. And for this, I'm going to find a pre-existing data set. Then choose a machine learning model, process your data, train your model, test your model, fine-tune your model. So the first thing I'm going to ask it is to give me a data set with cats and dogs. Where can I download a data set with these cats and dogs? All right, so it's gonna give me a few options. Kaggle, and then the Oxford IIIT pet data set, Stanford dogs data set. Okay, I think I'm gonna use the Oxford 3T pet data set. So let's find that. 37 category pet data set with roughly 200 images for each class. The images have a large variation in scale, pose, and lighting. Okay, so it has cats and dogs. It's around 800 megabytes in size. Okay, so I'm gonna download the data set and the annotations separately. Okay, there we go. Now while this is downloading, I'm gonna ask it to give me some code. Give me some example Python code to implement this. All right, so it's gonna tell me here's some example Python code. Shows you how you can use a convolutional neural network to train an AI model that detects cats and dogs. This code uses the Keras library, which provides a high-level interface for building and training machine learning models in Python. So first, you'll need to install the required libraries. So let's do that. Let's go to my folder here, INV, yes. All right, there we go. Now we have the environment. We can do conda activate AI ENV. And let's start installing our packages. 3 install TensorFlow macOS. We're gonna install the macOS version because I have an M1 Mac and TensorFlow probably doesn't work. And I've tested it before. It gave me a bunch of errors. So I'm gonna download the macOS version. All right, looks like that installed. And now we also have all the images downloaded. So now I'm gonna pip install Keras. 3 install Keras. Okay, so it's already installed. And now ChatGPT says, next you'll need to load and pre-process your data. You'll need to resize the images, convert them to grayscale, split the data into training validation sets. Here's some example code that shows you how you can do this using the Kaggle cats and dogs data set. Okay, so let's copy this code. And we are just gonna make one Python file. I'm gonna call it train.py. I'm gonna call this anddogs.py. That in there, copy our code, and we can install the extension since I don't have it yet. All right, now at the same time, let's place our data set in there. So where we have this stuff downloaded, now let's put images in here. Let's do the same for the annotations. So open annotations here, and let's copy that in our Visual Studio Code. So now we have the images of the cats you can see here, and we have the annotations as well. So let's go back to our Python and figure out how to do this, and let's see if this even runs. Cats and dogs.py. All right, so it said found 0 images belonging to 0 classes. And it says, once you have loaded and pre-processed your data, you can define and compile your CNN model. But it looks like it's not finding any images. So let me search this first and let's figure out why. Flow from directory. I'm actually going to download a easier data set. So I'm gonna use the Kaggle cats and dog data set that it recommends because it's gonna be easier for me than to use this Oxford one. So let's search Kaggle cats and dogs. And let's download this data set because it's gonna be already divided into the folders that I need. So there we go, I'm gonna let it download. Okay, so I got that downloaded. Let's expand the zip file. Kaggle's cats and dogs, here we go. And it looks like it's separated just like I need it to. So let's copy this pet images folder over to our VS Code. And from the ChatGPT code, let's change this to pet images and see if it detects these classes now. Okay, there we go. So it found 20,000 images belonging to 2 classes and 5,000 images belonging to 2 classes for the training and the validation. Perfect. So now let's move on to the second step. The ChatGPT tells me, once you have loaded and pre-processed your data, you can define and compile your CNN model. Here's some example code that shows you how to do this using the Keras sequential API. So here we define the model with all its layers and then we compile it. So let's copy this and put it in our code. Okay, so we define the model here with comtd, the activation ReLU, and there we go. And it looks like we're going to compile the model using the loss function binary cross entropy and then this optimizer. And the only metric we have is accuracy. I'm going to save this and let's see if it gives me out any errors. Nope, doesn't look like it had any errors. So that's good. We can move on to the next step. So it says finally, you can train your model by calling the fit function and passing in the training and validation data generators. So it looks like they didn't finish here. How can I train this model? I'm gonna ask you, how can I train the model? All right, here we go. Here's some example code. So we're gonna set history and then fit and all the steps and the validation steps. And tells me this code uses the fit method to train the model and the training data, which is provided by the train generator object. The steps for epoch and validation steps. Specify the number of steps to take in each epoch of training and validation. So it explains to me all of the parameters. Now let's copy this code and paste it at the bottom here. Now I'm going to run the code, make sure there's no errors. Okay, looks like we got an error. The use of load image requires PIL. So where is this? Line 47. Cannot import PIL image. So you need to install pillow. All right, let's do that. Pip install, actually pip3 install pillow. All right, so now we got that installed. Let's rerun it. Get any errors? Okay, there we go. So now it's gonna start training the model and we're gonna train it for 10 epochs. Oh, looks like we got an error. Cannot identify image file. Oh wow, are there? Okay, yeah, so this one's corrupted. So we weren't doing anything wrong. It just had corrupted stuff. So 11702, that's really annoying. Yeah, there we go. Delete this. Let's change all our code back to 150. And now, if we run our training, it should work. Okay, there we go. It is now finally training. So during training, the model will update its parameters. Once training is complete, you can use the train model to classify new images by calling the predict method of the model and passing it an image. How do I predict if cat or dog? It's gonna give me some example Python code. So let's wait for this to finish training. And actually, I'm gonna stop it here because I want to make sure that the model is saved. So we're going to do model save and then so I'm going to make a model folder here, model, and we're just going to do model save in model. And now let's run it and then our train model will save in this folder and then we can use it to predict images. So let's run the training. Okay, looks like it completed here, and let's check our model. There we go, we have the saved model. Now let's go back to ChatGPT and copy this code. I'm gonna make a new Python file called predict.py, and let's copy this in, /cat/0.jpg, and then let's load a couple cat images, 811 here, and then let's do 3 dogs, dog_image1 and dog_image2. And then let's just do the same, but change these to dogs. Okay, so to keep this brief, let's just simply create this image2array function for each of these. So I'm just gonna do this. Obviously, this isn't the most efficient way to go about it, but it's the fastest for now. Get rid of this, and then let's do... So now we have all these image arrays. So let's do image array. And then we're gonna do cat image array 1, cat image array 2, and we're gonna add the dogs as well. Now we can say for image in image array, we want to do this for all of them. And then now we also want for image in image array, we wanna predict all of them. Action equals model.predict. Image, and then we can also put this if statement in here and it'll tell me this. Now if I run this, it should have all the predictions. Okay, so let's go back to ChatGPT and tell it MP is not defined. And it should tell me that I need to import NumPy. To use the NumPy library in your Python code, you need to import it. Okay, let's do that and let's rerun it here. And now it says model is not defined. All right, so I know why now. We have to load our model from the save one. So if we go back to the saved model and then it says right here, loading the model back, you just need this. So we're gonna import Keras and then up here, we're gonna say, okay, model is going to be in model. Now let's rerun this and see if it worked. Okay, so after fiddling around with the code here, I got it to work. So I had to simplify it a little bit and run the prediction right after I expanded the dims. Now if we look at it, we have, this is a cat, this is a cat. Put it in, it's cat, 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 dog, dog, dog. And it predicted the first two correct. The third one was not a dog. So let's look at cat image array is cat 811 and see what that looks like. Okay, so it thinks this is a dog. It does kind of look like a dog. And then it got, well, this should be cat, this should be dog. Let's look at the dog it messed up on. That's gonna be the first one, dog zero, I think. Dog zero is a cat. Okay, I mean, I guess I can kind of see that. So okay, now that I did all these images, let's get an image off the web, just a random one, so we know it's not biased to its trained data. So image of a dog, dog image, and let's get image of a cat. Now let's find these and put them in here, and then I'm gonna get rid of these two, and I'm gonna get rid of these two and just do one each. Okay, I don't know if it can load WebP's, so I'm just gonna find another image. Make sure it's a JPEG and not like a WebP. Okay, now this is the cat we're gonna use. So rename, that's a JPEG. Dog, it's gonna be this one. Do this one and set it to JPEG. Now, if we run this, and boom, we get this is a cat and this is a dog. And those were the images. So it identified this as a dog correctly and it identified this as a cat correctly. In conclusion, ChatGPT can help you build AI, but you still need a lot of knowledge yourself about how to build these models because it's not really helpful with its debugging and it's not the best. So it can give you the information on how to start, but it can't give you like all the code and debug it for you. It's still not there yet. So yeah, that's it. I hope you enjoyed the video. Make sure to like and subscribe for more videos like this. And yeah, peace.